And then I was like, really? Are they by you? Wow. But yeah. So, that's a bit of a boo-boo now, isn't it? Well, hello my beauties. Welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki and this is Miss Muffet. And today, another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. I feel like I don't have a lot this week, looking at my Instagram feed. But yeah, then again, you never know with me, do you? So yeah, let's start with the look that I have. Yeah, I know it's pretty neutral, isn't it? Brown crease, but then this gorgeous green brow duochrome. Oh, I think it's my favorite green brown duochrome that I have, and no falsies. I don't know what is happening to me, but I did film this look. I filmed the look for Instagram. It's actually the OPV Spotlight palette, and let me show you real quick the shades that I used. I started with the color Dazzle Night. That one went outer V low in the crease. Then I blended it out with this shade, which is called Public Eye. A little bit deepening up with the black. And then on the lid and on the bottom is this gorgeous shade, which is called Notoriety. And this is so freaking pretty. Look. And it has, I don't even know if you can see it, but this is green with kind of a brownie shift. It's so pretty, but also a little bit of blue and purple. Oh, it's such a pretty shade that I wanted to slap on my face today. So yeah, lippy is L'Oreal Rouge Signature in Eye Stand. If it is on my Instagram, I think I can link a post. I just don't know for sure, if I'm being quite honest. But yeah, so yeah, I know I'm... and the no falsy part is basically it's really storming outside. Wind and rain. And I also didn't really feel like it today. So yeah, there's that. I don't know what's happening to me, but let's just get into the rest of the video, because I am rambling already. And we are only 2 minutes in. So yeah, this video series that I do on my channel every Monday is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is down in my description box, as is the community playlist that she created. My sources are also down there. The products I'm going to talk about today are down there. And if I have room left, the makeup that I have on my face will be down there as well. So that is basically it. Let's just kind of go to the side a little, so I can put up the pictures there. And let me open up my Instagram. Okay, here we are. So I have a little bit of an update, and hopefully I can make some of you very, very happy with this. This is from Gimme Glow Cosmetics. I initially wanted to say to you it has been restocked, but I also kind of read that it was sold out within 10 minutes. So there's that, but apparently they are bringing it back next Friday, or this Friday actually. That is what I see here. Oh! But I have an addition to that. So it says here, it will be restocked next Friday, so this Friday, if you are watching this. But even better, they have decided to make the palette permanent. The reason I don't really like limited edition products, and then especially if it is a very tiny stock, is the fact that I have a YouTube channel. And if I love a palette, I cannot say it to you for very long, you know, if they sell very, very quickly. So yeah, I'm actually very happy that they are bringing this back permanently, because from my understanding, it is a very well-loved palette and the quality is amazing as well. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of it. Let's go to drugstore. Let's go start with this, which is from Milani. They have added 6 new eyeshadow palettes to their Gilded range, including the Gilded Gold that was released in their holiday range. So the new palettes are, they're all gilded, the Luster Light, the Pastel, Twilight, Coast, Nude and Gold. It says here, available now at MilaniCosmetics.com for $20 each, coming to other retailers in January. What do you think about it? I'm bored, to be honest with you. There is nothing in this that I'm like, ooh, I like that. Could also be the pictures. But to be quite honest with you, I don't get really excited about Milani. I do have 2 Milani blushes and I have a bronzer. Yeah, they're nice. Yeah, that's basically it. So, yeah, I don't really get excited about Milani releases. For me, they are a little bit like L'Oreal, you know. It's just not really my vibe a lot of the time. But that was basically it. The next thing that I have is a new collab between Makeup by Mario and Sephora. And they are making a brush collection. It launches globally online and in store on December the 26th in over 25 countries. It is a limited edition brush set. Makeup by Mario is not sitting still, is he? So yeah, if I'm looking at these brushes though, you know what they remind me of? Where is it? They remind me of these. I have two of these. I wish I had more. These are the... Is this Sonia Kashuk? I think it is. It's this. Can you... Yes? I hope you could see it. I think this is Sonia Kashuk. I have these two brushes. I wish I had more. Because, oh, they are so good. But yeah, they kind of look similar. Very, very similar. So... I don't know, guys. I don't know prices. So yeah, there's that. Maybe I know prices when I'm editing that I can find out. But as of yet, I have no freaking idea. I don't think it will be cheap though. Just saying. So yeah, there's that. Let me know if you are excited. I'm not. I guess you did not know. But yeah. Okay. Next is from Catrice Cosmetics. And I have seen this one in store. It's a new mascara. It's their latest addition to their Glam and Doll family. They are all vegan. Or at least this one is vegan. It's the Glam and Doll Lash Colorist Volume Mascara. With a semi-permanent darkening effect. I have seen it in store. I have not, as of yet, not purchased it. Because I have two Glam and Doll mascaras here. These two. I have the Lash Growth and Volume Boost. And I have the False Lashes Mascara Waterproof. I have this one today. I really like it. This one, I don't really know if it works. To be quite honest with you. So, yeah. But I do really like the Glam and Doll range. Just so you know, the dark blue one in these from this line is a very, very nice dupe for the Bad Girl Bang. Just saying, I do really want to try this one though. Just because I really like the Glam and Doll mascara range. But yeah, if you have, let me know how you like it. I do know that you have to give it a little bit of time. They also have a brow mascara in that semi-permanent line. For me, I started noticing a difference, slight difference, granted, but a difference after about 3 weeks. So there is that. And yeah, I don't know. I have pretty black lashes, but the tips are lighter. So I do really want to try this one. So yeah. What do they retail for? I think here around 4 euros, I believe. But I'm not sure. I think it's around that price. But yeah. Okay, next is, it would not be a Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases without Colourpop. This is the only one I have seen so far. Let me check Colourpop's site really quickly. Okay, no new one release this week. Wow, Colourpop, are you sick? Anyway. Sorry. Yeah, they have released this, which is the Hola Chola palette, and it is a collaboration between them and Becky G. So yeah, I like the outer packaging. I like that aesthetics. I really, really do. For the rest, I'm sorry to say, I should have named this an anti-haul. I think it's a boring release, but that is me. I am about to say, I'm not really into neutrals. I do like neutrals, but I like the cool toned neutrals, so the very cool grayish browns or the pukey green, those kind of off, those are the browns that I like. But yeah, for me personally, this is a very, very, very boring palette. Let me know what you think about it. I know there are a lot of you who love neutrals. And, well, why shouldn't you? I don't know. Not everyone can be a colorful lover just like me. So, yeah. But what do you think about this release? You know what I like about this palette? I like the red, I like the gray, and I like the black. And that's basically it. So that's three shades. But yeah. So guys, let me know what you think about it. There's more. There are also bronzers and lippies. And what I do really like though is this. And that is that roller gloss. I remember roller glosses. They were gloopy and yucky. But yeah, everyone had a roller gloss. I so remember that. So if I were to get anything of this line, it would be that freaking roller gloss, just because it's nostalgic, you know? So yeah, let me know down below what you think. Oh yeah, let's go to this. When I saw this, I was like, ooh, they are pretty. And then I was like, really? Are they by you? Wow, because these are by Morphe. And I am actually really pleasantly surprised by these two. I like the green one because looking like it, there are a little bit of those off greens, you know, a little bit of those baby pukey diarrhea greens. I like that. I don't know. But I really, really like the green palette, actually. I also like the one with the purpley one, but I am drawn more to the greeny one. They retail for $18, and you have the 18B, which is making bank, and then the 18F, which is talking flirty. I don't know which is which, but I do like these, and I could actually see myself trying, especially the green one, maybe the purpley one as well. I need to see different pictures. I actually can see myself using those, to be quite honest with you. So yeah, I am pleasantly surprised. What do you think? Maybe you have tried them already, because as far as I know, they are online already. Let me know. Let's go next to Wicked Sister Cosmetics. This is their Black Lodge eyeshadow palette. It is Twin Peaks inspired. Well, and it is launching the 25th. You get, I said 9 shades, you get 1 glitter, you get 4 mattes and 4 shimmer shades. I cannot see by this picture, and I hope that the trend will kind of stay in this year, the pressed glitters in eyeshadow palettes. If you have a bigger palette, I have palettes here with pressed glitters in them. I also have bigger palettes with pressed glitters in them. I don't mind them as much in bigger palettes, but if it is a 9 pan palette, I feel like it is a waste, because I don't use pressed glitters enough to warrant having them in a 9 pan smaller palette, you know? It doesn't do it for me, personally, this palette, if I'm looking at this picture. Yeah, no, it's not for me. Then the next thing that I have from them is another palette, and that is one that is inspired by The Shining. Also a pressed glitter, looks like, and the color Red Room, which is the red, is unfortunately a pressed glitter. I think that this color story grabs me a little bit better, but still, yeah, I'm sorry, it's not for me, but maybe it is for you. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of it, and I will leave the site down below. So yeah. Let's go to this one next, which is from Haunted Beauty Shop. You see here highlighters. It is the Winter Witches and Silent Fright. They are coming soon. I don't have any more. However, I think that's it. Yeah, it says coming soon, but Winter Witches and Silent Fright. I think Winter Witches is a duochrome. Let me check, because I saw something else. Yeah, the Lantern Lights highlighter in the shade Winter Witches, which was the white. It looks like a shimmery white in the pan, but becomes alive on the skin with a subtle color shift from an icy blue green to pink. It's not really something that I would wear, I think, but it does sound really pretty. And I really like the aesthetics. I like them. I really, really like this. So that is why I wanted to mention it to you. Okay, let's go to the next thing, which is, do not do that. I had that one, let's next go to this, which is from Likely Makeup, because they are coming out with a new blush palette. You see the palette, you see the swatches. This is called the Fairy Blush Palette. It has released on Friday the 13th, so that was last Friday. Do I have prices? Oh yeah, I have a price here as well. The The Fairy Blush Palette retails for $23. It's cruelty-free, vegan, and eye-safe. I would probably use this as a quad eyeshadow palette, to be quite honest with you, because I don't really see myself using a teal blush. But that is me personally. So, yeah, what do you think? I have read mixed thoughts about this, and yeah, you know, I am not opposed to palettes that you can do multiple things with. Hell, a lot of the time when I use an eyeshadow palette, if there is a nice blush shade for me, I use an eyeshadow as a blush or an eyeshadow as a highlighter, and vice versa, because I don't care. But yeah, let me know what you think. As an eyeshadow quad, I really, really like it, but then the pans are huge. So yeah, I have to be quite honest and say that I liked her first release, that Clown Blush palette, better, because that was more up my alley. I think that is a better explanation of it. I do really think that that pink and the orangey would be really, really pretty as a blush. And yeah, I don't know. You know, if I go to a festival and I am very in a fairy mood, I could see myself using the other two. But yeah, it's kind of I don't know, maybe love-hate is maybe a little bit too strong, but it's both. I like it and I don't really like it. You know, let me know down below what you think of it. I'm curious. I know there will be a ton of people who would love this. And yeah, basically, what is there though is you can just slap it in your purse and use it as a blush palette and an eyeshadow. I do like that though. Okay, let's go next to Color Junkie Cosmetics. I had never heard of them. So yeah, and this is, let's see, the Spacebound palette. It is their latest creation. It says here, it's the world's first and only rocket ship eyeshadow palette. Yeah, featuring three star-shaped glitter formulas and a removable magnetic lid. I like that part, but I don't like the pressed glitters in there, but that's me. So pre-orders are available now, and you can get a $10 discount. It is limited edition and limited quantities. I will leave the site down below. Overall, I do like the color story though. I would have liked it personally better if the pressed glitters were shimmers, but yeah, again, that is me. I don't really know what it retails for, and I also don't know why Instagram says that comments on this post have been limited. I don't know. I have no idea. I think that's a bit weird. But yeah, let me know down below what you think of it, if you know Color Junkie Cosmetics and all that goodness. So yeah, let's get to the next one, which is, oh yeah, from Etude House. They have such great releases. So yeah, in celebration of the Year of the Rat, Etude House officials are launching a Lucky Together collection featuring Tom and Jerry. That's so old school for me. I grew up watching Tom and Jerry. So yeah, I think this is cute. The first wave of collection launches the 21st of December in Japan. The last collection, that Rudolph collection, I did find it somewhere on a site that does ship internationally. I just don't remember where exactly. It wasn't on YesStyle, it was a different site. But yeah, I think this is cute, guys. It's not for me. But I did want to mention it because I do really like stuff like this, you know? Okay. Next. Let's go to, what's this? Oh yeah, this is from Chichi. Oh, sorry. Sometimes with Instagram names, I need to put a spacing somewhere so I know how I need to say something. Sometimes it takes a while. They have released four neutral palettes that kind of look a lot alike for me. But yeah, that does not really matter. Let me tell you which ones they are. You have Socialite, which is a selection of neutral, taupe, mauve and brown mattes with rich shimmery golds, rosy pinks, dusty mauves and pops of soft berry shades. Then you have the Spices 2, which is a selection of neutral and brown mattes in both cool and warm undertones with rich shimmery golds, bronzes and spicy shades in a variety of textures. Goddess 2 is a selection of neutral to warm red, berry red, brown and orange mattes with rich shimmery shades in golds, bronzes, berries and rusty shades with pops of purple. Then Diva 2, a selection of neutral brown, mustard and orange toned mattes with rich shimmery golds, bronzes and browns in a variety of textures. So basically I don't really know, to be quite honest, how the conversion rate is for Australian dollars to euros. So I don't know if it is a high price point. I don't know how their formula is. I do know that it is not for me. It could very well be the pictures though, because the pictures look a little bit flat on my phone. I just think, yeah, I like them more than the Milani ones, so that's for sure. But they are not for me, but I did want to mention them to you anyway. And yeah, they are based in Australia. Let me know if you have tried anything from them and how the quality is. Okay, next is something that this is not going to make any sense because I need to use Google Translate, which is going to be hilarious. So let's see where I have my translation button there. Okay, so this picture that you see, or you see, I think you see a bunch of pictures. I think. Oh, this is from Sigil Inspired. It says here super news, and this is written in Russian, and I'm using Google Translate, so if it does not make any sense, it is because of that. Let's see. These are big sets of mini testers in gift packs. They were available to order. I don't know if they are all available as of yet, or that they are sold out, but I thought this was cute and I wanted to mention it. She has 5 kinds, 16 shades in each set. They are in a box. And the box price is included in the bundle price. So let's see. So you have the order, that's what it says here. The order of color, which is the bright tones, and she says here, it says here a set 16 shades, 4 bright rose, 3 rows of bright satins, and 1 row of bright mica. And for who is this geared, or who is this geared toward? Everyone who wants rainbow. Then you have the order of darkness, it's cold and neutral tone, cool and neutral tones. One who loves cool and mysterious shades. That's basically it, because the rest does not make any sense. Then you get the order of the woods, warm and neutral. Then you get order of charm. It's some light shades, bright accent tones, brown satins and prismatics. And then we have the order of beauty. These are shades with different textures. So you have radiant mica. I'm just going off of Google Translate here. A number of basic shimmers or mattes, I think. A number of basic satins and bright accent colors. And she says here it's geared towards lovers of evening makeup, makeup artists and all that. And you can order them on the official website of Sigil. It is in the section promotions and useful in the catalog. Quantities limited. Wow. I saw these and this looked so fun. And obviously I like the bright colored one. I also like the cool one though. Yeah, I think it's the first two that I like. I don't know how I have done them, but the bright one, obviously. And then the one next to it, which has, I don't know, the cooler ones. The bottom fingers is one very, very blue, multi-chromey goodness and such. I don't know, but I like those two. So, yeah. Maybe I need to check out what these sets retail for. Because this is maybe a good way to try stuff from her, you know? Next is from Blush Tribe. She has launched new titanium dust pigments. And they look really pretty. I also think I had swatches from her. From those titanium dusts. Yeah, here. So let me save that as well. So you have seen a picture with arms and pots. That's basically it. They look really pretty, guys. I have this from Blushstripe. I don't even know if it is a titanium dust or if it is a loose fine glitter. I don't know, but it's very, very pretty nonetheless. I got this with my Layla 2 palette when I ordered it. But yeah, very, very pretty. I wanted to mention it. Let me know if you are excited about that. I didn't get rid of my gum because it's annoying the hell out of me. Okay, let's do that. Okay, let's go next to Odin's Eye Cosmetics. And they say here, more products of their Ulva. I need to say it like that. Ulva, I don't know. It is an A with two dots. So if you are from there, please, can you please then leave in the comment section how I need to pronounce it? Because I really would like to know. But yeah, let's see. There will... Let's see if I have pictures instead of moving stuff. No, shit. Damn it. But anyway, they have a new eyeshadow palette. Yes, they have a new eyeshadow palette and it is a bigger palette. It's cute, guys. So yeah, I have their Freya palette, their first eyeshadow palette, and it is one of my favorites. I really, really love that palette. I recently did a video with it. I will link it down below. But yeah, quality was really, really nice. I don't know how the quality is on this one. I also don't know what it retails for, but I do think it's really, really pretty. So yeah, there is that. Let me know if you have ever tried Odin's Eye Cosmetics. They are based in Sweden, by the way, in case you don't know. So yeah. So let's go to, what was this? To this one from Charlotte Tilbury. It is another addition to the Pillow Talk line. It's the Pillow Talk Instant Eye Palette that includes 12 shades inspired by the cult classic shade Pillow Talk. It says here, coming soon. I like that they kind of have split it apart a little bit, but yeah. So you have your day, you have your desk, then you have your date and your dream. I can see this appealing to a lot of people. Just not me, but I did want to mention it to you anyway. And I remember that it was her collection from last year, that eyeshadow palette that was so freakishly expensive for me. If it is not for you, well, you know, I'm not judging, but it is freakishly expensive for me. So yeah, let me know what you think of it. Maybe you are really, really excited about this. Let me know down below. Okay, let's go next to Too Faced, because they are releasing their Lunar New Year themed limited edition, wait for it, repackaging of their original multi-use Diamond Fire highlighter in Diamond Light. So yeah, I do like how it looks. I really like how it looks. I like the aesthetics of it, but it is just the fact that it is repackaging of last year's. Yeah, you know, for a brand, I can see it. I can see why they would do it. But yeah, if you are, for instance, a collector of these highlighters, you basically are paying a lot of money for a different box. That's basically it. And maybe, you know, instead of doing this, they should just do the box. You know, make these highlighters in loose form as well, that you can buy different boxes. So let's go to this one then, which is from MAC. It is their Chinese New Year Limited Edition Collection. It is... going to launch in selected markets, and it includes face products, lip products, and eyeshadow palette. What we have seen here, at least. Oh, this looks really, really pretty. The only thing I don't really get, though, is why there is a dragon embossed in the highlighter, and it is going to be the year of the rat and not the year of the dragon. But yeah, so that's a bit of a boo-boo now, isn't it? At least in my eyes it is. So, yeah. For the rest, I like it. It's just, why a dragon? Or maybe it is a picture of one of the 12. Maybe they are doing 12 zodiac signs and then one of them is a dragon embossing. It could be. I don't know. But it does look really pretty. The eyeshadow palette looks pretty boring. But yeah, I do like the outer packaging. So there's that. I don't know if it will come here. Maybe it's just for the Asian markets. I don't know. Let's go next to Crow and Pebble. It says here, did you know we have bundles for sale? Save a percentage of your order by choosing a preset bundle. These are the swatches of various blush bundles, actually. Let's see, face products each have 4 products in them, and eyeshadow bundles each have 5 shadows. She is very, very busy updating the website with them. Okay, so she says here, the swatches were applied very heavily to show the shades. They all shear down quite easily while remaining pigmented and blend like a dream. But the swatches that you see here are of the face products. I did order a blush from them. My order hasn't come in yet. It is on its way to me. So yeah, there's that. I ordered a purplish blush. So yeah, I cannot wait to try it. But I think that bundles are a very, very good idea, because a lot of the time, at least for me, when I go and search for loose shades or a single shade, I kind of get overwhelmed if I have a lot of choice. So I think it is a very good idea that she has made bundles. So yeah, by the way, I do have a code with a Crow Pebble. It is down in my description box. It is not really affiliated. No, it's not affiliated, but you save and I earn store credit. That's basically it. So yeah, I have one thing left and I hope I can finish it before my battery dies. But yeah, the last thing that I have is from Tarte, because they are expanding their Shape Tape range with the Shape Tape Glow Wand. It's a liquid highlighter. So yeah, they are available now at QVC in 8 shades for $25. And the full launch will happen in January on Tarte Cosmetics and Ulta Beauty. What is it? Is it a wand or is it a sponge? What is it? Oh, you get both. So you can choose? Okay. So yeah. What do you think? Did we need this? I don't really know what to think of it. At first I thought they were kind of doing something to their Shape Tape, you know, concealer thingy. But yeah, no, they're glow wands. So you can glow like a worm in the dark or something. I don't know, people. I don't know. Maybe you can be like Harry Potter and wave your glowy dark. I don't know. And I need to stop because I'm... yes. I'm getting a little bit, I don't know, fangy, ranty. I watched the originals yesterday on Netflix, the last season. Not completely, but I am at episode 8, so maybe my fangs are a little bit growing. I don't know really what's wrong today. I do know that this was it. This was everything that I wanted to talk about this week in the Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. If you tagged me, thank you so very, very much. If you did tag me, but I did not mention what you tagged me in, send it through me through DM on Instagram, because I don't see every tag that I get, unfortunately. So there is that. Yeah, that was it. I am going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day. No, first I'm going to thank you so much for watching. Yes, that was it. Now I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye guys.